Well, we raised the stakes. Raised the stakes and changed the environment. But it was a conscious decision to keep the structure, which we were all very happy about, because I think that I, as a fan, want to see a Miss Knight again. I want to see these guys have to get their way out of a crazy situation that was like the first one. But you change the scenario to Bangkok from Vegas, and everything follows suit. And then we also have one of the Wolfpack getting married, so that's a whole different thing.
Yeah, and actually the script reflects it. Like where the script picks up, the relationships are established. You know, a lot of the groundwork has been done. The same is true for us as buddies. Like we became close on Hangover 1 and kind of showed up for work excited to kind of just get back into that groove. You know, day one of production was the...
Oh, the IHOP.
It was IHOP, and that was like... It was just fun. It was like, we're back, here we go, and it's just a silly scene. It's not too complicated, so it was sort of fun to start off that way.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah, and we did have fun with that scene.
I also had a lot of fun in the dentist's office with you.
We did. Yeah,
it was a lot. That got cut down a little bit. Those are sort of some fun, ridiculous stuff in there.
So two scenes I wasn't in.
Yes.
I got to say... I just love, for some reason, that always stick in my memory of, like, the end of the monk scene in the monastery. I just, you know.
Yep.
I really, when we get beaten up, and then we are met by the head monk.
That is your line, Zach's line in that scene is one of my favorite in the whole movie.
That was as if that was a separate movie. That was a 10-page scene. It was like a little short that we shot. So much happens in that scene, and it's very ambitious for a movie to start out with a 10-minute scene, or however long it is, 10 pages. And I have to say that I felt very honored to be, the one who wakes up, because Stu woke up last time, and it was such a classic. Wake up. I mean, it was just indelible. And I actually remember when I was like, oh, Phil's going to wake up? But I really liked the way that it happened, because it was kind of the perfect thing, because you reveal Alan, and then it's the reveal of Stu, and then it's the reveal of the monkey, and then the reveal of Chow. It's like this perfect sequence of events.
I will add that I felt very honored to be the one in my underwear this time, because that was Zach.
That was
the first one.
Well, actually, no, Zach was naked.
Yeah.
Zach didn't have any underwear on. The first time. Wake up scene.
You didn't?
No. He just had a shirt on. Remember he was like this? He's running around.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. No underwear.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm all right, cutting new ground.
You were in the underwear.
Underwear guy.
You were the underwear guy in the first one.
Underwear.
Remember in Vegas? Vegas.
Oh,
this.
My little yeah, that's right. There's really gratuitous scene of me getting ready to go out just fully in my
underwear. Totally in your underwear.